dans ce stade de Nigeria. This message is about bringing our guests, those Chicago guests that were kidnapped by Boko Haram. Boko Haram was the one that directed the kidnap of those guests. The truth that we know shall surely set us free. Not that it was the one front of it. Boko Haram was sent, an agent, he was sent to kidnap those guests. The kidnap was done through the Nigeria politician. I come to you today in the name of God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Israel, the maker of heaven and earth, the one that has the key of the whole universe, the one that can say, today I can take your life and you can go home. The one that you that have the control over your soul and your spirit and your body. I've delivered this message last year, but by the time I was doing my YouTube, by mistake I took some of the message off, but I couldn't understand how to reload it back again. But that's why I'm giving you this message back. Boko Haram was sent, was used. Who organized the kidnap of those guests? The work was done inside the house of your parliament. When they said the house of Haram, inside the government house. Those children, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Israel, the maker of heaven and earth, we watch over their soul and their spirit and their body, wherever they are. The prayer are going around the whole earth for those children. And I know one day the God Almighty will find a way to wipe the tear of those children's parents, and including the children and their family, to wipe the tear away. You all Nigeria politics, they are in Nigeria. You have no heart. Those of you, because you are choosing yourself, you did not allow God to choose. Those who you put, you anoint and you ordain them to be a minister to look after the people. Before you can be able to look after the people, you need to have a heart of love. But you put somebody in the position that the person hasn't got the heart. There is a lot of seed of Satan you put in that policy seat and you call them governor or whatever you name them over there. Now let me come here. God knows that this children kidnap, this children matter really worry my heart, that I even went on prayer. I did a lot of prayer first. I said, God, what's going on? This is just too much. The pain was just too much. I don't know how some of the parents will cope. And I was told that maybe some of the parents even go mad or some of them die because of the shock. We should put ourselves in their shoes. If it was us, we will do worse than that. The God gave me a full revelation about some of what's going on there. And this message, I'm going to address it to the Nigeria politics. Those you who are in politics. God of Abraham, God of Isaac, the maker of heaven and earth, he know and he see all what you are doing. You may be thinking what you are doing is secret. I wish God opened your eyes. I wish God opened the curtain for you, the curtain of heaven for you. For you to be able to know that he see everything, if he show you the picture and the mirror of whatever you all are calling secret, you will be frozen in your heart. For you to know that God see everything and he know what you are doing. Those children were kidnapped. I thought because it really pained me that I went on prayer and fasting, that he really, at the end, I was admitted in the hospital for it. I couldn't even tell them in the hospital that I was on fasting or prayer because of the guests that were kidnapped in Nigeria. I couldn't say such a thing like that. The shock the pain I was going through, while I went on prayer, I usually even pray for the whole world, not even especially for those guests. But when the case of those guests came in, it really pained me because January that year, 2014, God showed me some revelation, which I was thinking, I was blaming myself. I was saying, is this those guests? Are they those guests? I don't know. Please, God, help me. This January, in that revelation, 2014, when God showed me, I saw a group of guests. They lined them up inside the building. The building was very high up. As they lined up them up, I saw hands stretched out through the, there's a gate, big fence gate. The hand stretched out through the gate out. As I first saw the hand, I was walking on the road, I saw the hand stretched out through the gate. As I was moving forward, I then hear crying. People are crying inside the building. The building was so, it's a red building. It was high up. As people are crying, I can hear the crying as I was walking on the street. As they are crying, I then move forward. I saw black guests. They line them up. Maybe they are 8, maybe 10 or 9. They line them up. The small one in the front and then the big one at the back. They line them up according to their eyes. As they line them up there, I can hear their cry. Then they stretch their hands through the gate, out from the gate, and they say, please help us, please help us, please help us. As they ask me that I should please help them, because I was outside on the road, but they are inside the building that they locked them up. As they were crying and asking me to please help them, I was just looking at them. I was worried, I was looking at the world. Then I saw a tall black man. It's like the size of the building. It's very high up. Then he points out to me, he said, you that can't forgive. It's like he was telling me, you that can't forgive. You are the one that you wanted to save this people, save this girl. No. In the street there, I went on my knee and I started praying. I said, God, I forgive anybody that offended me. I know I've been through a lot of pain. I know I've been through a lot of things. Please, I forgive them. I take them out of my heart. I forgive. As I was kneeling down in that street, in that dream, saying I forgive, I just woke up to life. When I woke up, all my body was sweating, like if I just come out from the gym or something. Then I went on my knee. Then I picked my phone. I phoned a lady. I said, I sent her a text. I said, Happy New Year. I sent my greeting to all your family, and she sent me a text back. She said, who is this? I said to myself, oh, she took my number from her phone, or what is this? That she didn't even recognize it was me. I didn't respond back to her text message, but I was still on the shock. I was still on the phone, I was still on my knees praying and asking God that I forgive all, I forgive all, please God help me. Then as I was on my knees there, I saw the gate of that building that was open, and I saw guests coming out. As they are coming, running out of the floor, you can see their legs touching their back. They are running, and as they are running out, I saw some men, young boys, black boys too, among of them. They all are all running, coming out. I said to myself, When I saw it, I said, it's only the guests that I saw. I didn't know that the boys too were kidnapped with them. And that went on. That's when I went on fasting, when I heard in April that some guests were kidnapped from their secondary school. I was thinking to myself, God, are they the one or not? What's going on? Please help me. And I really went on prayer and fasting that the children, it really touched me. Even nowadays, I can't even look at them on the news. If they show anything about the Chickabouts death or the death, I can't even open my eyes. I just change it to another channel because it's too painful to look at. That went on. Another revelation God gave me last year, because he know that my heart really went on those death. And at the time, God was telling me that it's like, I can't love the product more than he, the manufacturer of the product. God is one of those children. He knows that my heart is going deeper to them. That's why he was telling me as well that he too loved them more than how I loved them. Then he showed me this revelation. I saw in this revelation, it's about few revelations about those things. This revelation, I saw a man, how your house of rest is inside, it's a big building like a court. And I saw a man. Then the man, how those girls was kidnapped, how those girls was saved. God just bring my mind out back to how Joseph was sold. Joseph was sold by some people. Those who kidnapped those who arranged the kidnap of those children, they are between the children, between those guest families. It will sound funny, but it's not funny. The work was done between the Hausa. God never lied. The secret of the Lord is with those, it's with those that he loves, and he reveals to them. The girls were kidnapped by their own people, and they kidnapped them and give them and hand over them to Boko Haram. The kidnap job was done by the Hausa, by the North Island. They are the ones that arranged this thing. The kidnap was done by the Hausa. Those people who work in the house of rent, the northern people that work in the house of rent, they are the ones that arrange. I come to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. I can speak as the Lord living. Those that arrange the kidnap of those people, they are the outsiders. They are the people amongst themselves. You know, where you will find good people, you will find bad people. The seed of Satan, they miss where the seed of children are. It's like hand to hand. Joseph was sold by some people. It's like when I was thinking about it, God just bring my thought back to Joseph. Joseph was sold by some people. It's the outsiders that some of them that work in that house of rent, those are the ones that organize this thing. And they pass it to Boko Haram. God showed me this clear vision, dream. I saw it like in a building, like how the house of rent is. I saw it. Then I saw a man. It's like the judge. A lot of black men are sitting there. It's like the judge. Then he said to them, he said to one of them, they sent two men to go and do the job. He said to one of the men, he said, but we told him to take them. That's what the man was saying to them. He said, but we told you to take them, but we did not tell you to do any evil to them, to sleep with them or to do any evil to them. That's what the judge was saying. He said, but we told you to take them, but we did not tell you to do any evil to them. Inside the place was just like House of Parliament, like how House of Parliament is in England. That's how the place is. The building was big and the judge sat. He said to the two men that they called to the front, he said to them, but we told you to take them, but we did not tell you to do any evil to them. That went on, and then I see one of the guests went to the parents. I saw a mother that a child went to her. Then the child was telling the mother what they do to them, that some of them were pregnant and some of them they took their baby, all kind of things that they did to them there. That's when another part that God showed me about this. I went about two or three months to go. I saw in a room, they divide, it's like a building, they divide the guests in a two building. It's in a building, but they divide them in a two room. They are sitting down, some are sitting down, some are lining on a bench. The first room I saw, some guests are lining on the table, like our table is bench, they sleep on the bench. Then I went to another room, in this dream, I went to another room, I saw some guests, they sit on the floor, here I'm coming, they sit on the floor. And I saw a man, one man and two ladies, they are watching them, they are looking at them as they are sitting on the floor. Like they are guiding them, they are monitoring them. Then I saw one of the girls wanted to run out. She wasn't happy. She wanted to run out. Then I was pleading to that girl. I said she should not be annoyed with her parents because of the school that they send them. That is because wherever you go and look for a job, you need a qualification. They will ask for your qualification. That's why I was pleading to one of the girls that wanted to run out. Then I said to her that she should not be annoyed with her parents. That is because when you want to get a job, what they ask you in that job is your qualification. This is a dream that I was saying to. In that dream, I was telling the girl, I said she should not be annoyed with the parents. That is because of the school, of the job. Like if you want to go and look for any job, they will ask for your qualification. That's why your parents send you to that school in this dream. That's why I was telling to the guests. They put them in a room. It's two. They divide the room into one. They divide the room into two. One room, I saw guests lying on the bench. Then I went to the other room. Then I saw guests sitting on the floor. And there is a teacher there. Then when I said that to the to that girl that wanted to run away, then I said to the teacher, I said, you, some of you are using them as a maid. That's what I said in that dream. I said some of in that dream when I was talking to the teacher, I said some of you are using them as a maid when some of you are sleeping with them. That's what I told them in that dream. That's when then God showed me another one that I saw in a room. It's like those children, they are not in one place. If the government is looking for them in one place, no, they are not in one place. They divide them. As someone said that they put in a room. They line them on the bench. Then I saw another set that was sitting in another room, on the seat on the floor, and they have about two ladies and one man. They are looking at, they are monitoring them. I saw two ladies and one man, they are monitoring them. Then I said to them, some of you are using those guests as a maid. And then some of you are sleeping with them. That's why I told the guests this. Then I saw in another room, like upstairs room, they have guests there. Those guests, they are about 50, not many, they are about 50. Not up to 100. I don't think they're up to 100. They sat on the chair. Inside the room, they put them, was very dark. They're about 50 or 60 or under 100. But they are something around 50 or 60 or 70, but they are all under 100 or under 80 because they sit on the long chair. The chair they sit together, line by line, but they sit together. God revealed this to me. I saw them, they sit together. And I saw a man in front of them. And I saw one of the girl in the front. She was carrying a baby, like they played with her baby. She had a baby in her hand. She was playing with her baby, carrying her baby like this. Playing with her baby. Then I saw a man. One man was in charge of about 50 or 60 guests that I saw in a room. One man was in charge of them. Then the man was telling them that we told you not to go and do nothing. That's what the man was saying, that we told you not to go and do nothing. Then in that dream, as I was standing there looking at them, I said, that's me, you want them to become housewives. I said, that means you want them to become housewives. Nigeria politics, you got blood in your hand. I think it doesn't vote for you. If I'm in that country, your voting card, I will cut it and burn it in fire. Because I won't involve my hand with something that will kill this woman being. It's wasteless if somebody go and vote for you. Those who are in politics in that country, because you are wasting people's time. If they go and vote for you, they are just wasting their time, because you sit in a place. That's why I said to you, the secret of the Lord is with his people. You sit in a place, you arrange who to become a next president, who to become a next government. You did not count the vote of people as worthy. No, you don't do according to what those people vote for. No. Heaven will be your witness if you said you vote according to the vote that the people went out to vote. If you say you can't don't vote, and that's what you used to do to put the government or the president, whatever you choose there. If you say you use those votes that the people went out to vote, if you said you use it to put people in the position, it's the vote that you can't their vote. Heaven and the head that you work on will be your judgment, because nothing you've done is in secret. The president that you ordain now, how you do it in the room with the man, everything, the secret of the Lord is open. That's why I say, I pity those who went out to go and vote. It won't be the first, because God said to me that before I was born, since Nigeria take over their own independence from the and European people, Nigeria has been choosing their own government. And that's why the country of Nigeria is like that. And God said, as long as they are doing that, the country, whoever they ordain, whoever they put there, will be destroying the country for them. Because they are choosing by themselves. They did not allow him to choose. Get this book. I did it last year. It's called God Prophetic Word to All Nigeria. You can get it on Amazon or on Lulu. It was out last year. But inside that book, God says, since that country has taken their independence, that country has chosen their own government by themselves. You call yourself a president. The whole world now knows the shame of Nigeria. You put people in the seat where God did not ordain them to be. And then you are fighting with human being life. You are playing game with human being life. You got your own family there at home. Some of you, your children don't even go to school in Nigeria. Some of you, your children go to school outside Nigeria. Some of you, your children go to school outside. They go to school in Europe, in America, in London, in France, in Germany, all over the world. But the poor of the land, you waste their soul. Don't forget, inside this book, God said the blood in that land is crying to him for revenge. If you are killing them, kidnapping them, don't think their blood doesn't speak. If they can't speak, if they have no lawyer to judge for them, don't forget, their blood will speak and their blood go up, and then that's what we judge. You arrange. The kidnap of those guests was arranged from the House of Parliament in Nigeria. I serve the living God. I serve God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Israel. And I know what he showed me. Because he know that if those girls really worry me. I told you I went on fasting, that during the fasting I collapsed at home, that they got to call ambulance to take him to the hospital. Because I was on fasting. I said, God, what's going on about those girls? God, what's going on? It really pained me, God. I said, what's going on? Not until when God started showing me things, and God was saying to me that, like, I can't love the product more than the product. God loved those children. We feel the pain here on earth about those children. God himself feels it more than we fear. Then you think you are doing something evil. You think you will go away with it. No. God of Abraham, God of Isaac, we deal with you. And the way we deal with you, your children will pay for it. I don't blame you, because God said the seed of Satan is in that land of Nigeria. And you haven't got no heart to become a president, to be friendship with people. You need to have a heart of love. To look after people, you need to have a heart of love. They put you in a position as a whatever governor, whatever you all put yourself into, but you have no heart. If you have heart, you will not arrange for somebody else's children to be kidnapped from their secondary school. Their children want the best for them. They did not send them to local school that they will come, they will go home and they will come back every day. They send them to where they can be able to focus their education. They take them there so that they can be in the boarding house. The hassle that some of those parents struggle, the pain that some of those parents go through, for them to be able to put their children there. All those things. If somebody cries from the heart, their cry is more heavier in the eyes of God than you putting money down on the saving. A single cry that those parents cry, if God waits for you on this case and see what you've done. I'm going to address this message to Nigeria politics. Bring back the Chicago girls. Bring back those girls. If America, Europe, London, Germany, if they are going around and saying they want to, they are going to find the man that kidnapped them. Before they find the seed of Satan that kidnapped them, they first got to deal with you of Nigerian politics. Mekadia, you know where those children are. The person that organized the kidnap of those girls was done from the house of Fred. It's from inside that big building that the children, whoever organized it, was organized. That's why I said, because you are serving Satan. Satan will tell you that nobody will see this. What you do is secret. But I serve the creator of heaven and earth, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Israel, the one that have the whole universe, the one that have each one of us in his hand. Once I was praying, I have the map of the whole world. I use it to pray for all the children of God, wherever they are. When I first bought the map, it really pained me. I said, God, you got a lot of children to look after. You got a lot of us to look after. God know that I really pity him in heaven. I said, God, look at the map. Look how big it is. You got a lot of us to look after. How are you going to do it, God? Then God was telling me that he had each one of us in his hand. He gave me a message in his hand. He said, he got the whole world. In his hand, he got the whole world. In his hand, he got the whole world. In his hand, he got the whole world. In his hand. You think you got the whole world in your hand. You think you have power in your hand to do whatever you want to do. But know that there's somebody above you. He has the power and the authority. Those girls that you arrange to, is for them to be kidnapped. Know that as you put your feet on the floor in Nigeria, their blood will be haunt you. Their blood, their soul, their spirit will haunt you, will haunt all your seed, will haunt all your trees, unless you repent. God is a merciful God. The God that I serve, you all serve Satan that hasn't got no mercy. But the God that I serve, if you go to him and say, please God, I know I've sinned, forgive me. He will forgive you. He will have mercy on you. I'll release those gifts. I'll reign to release those gifts. Wherever you kept them in different locations. For you to know that I wasn't in Nigeria, I'm not a relative to any politics or there that I will know all this. It's God Almighty. He revealed the deep and the secret. When you all are choosing to become a president, you all are doing all these things. God is just laughing. Because you think you are playing a game with people's life, but God is just laughing. You waste people's life. People will walk, trek, go and line up all day to go and do their voting. But their voting, you put them in the rubbish because you already have your own voting. You already know who you are going to put as a president, who you are going to put as a governor. You don't do it according to the will of God. Heaven is your witness when you are doing your voting in that country, Nigeria. When the first time President Obama wanted to go into the presidency, I was here in England. At home, in my dream, in the middle of the night, God just revealed him to me. I saw him, I said, what's this? Immediately, I get up on my knees from my place. I went on my knees and I went in prayer for him. I said, God, please help him. Let your will be done in that country where he is. few days after I, when they are doing the voting who is going to win, I told my people, I said, I am sure it's that black man because of what God showed me. But in you, that my people in Nigeria, what God will show me about you, it's not even good to even open my, it's really, it's too painful for somebody to even talk about it. I may not even know, I can't even reach the White House where Obama is for me to tell him that, you know, somebody will, God will somebody up in the middle of the night to pray for you, no? But you, Nigeria, can somebody say God wake me up in the middle of the night to pray for my president, those who government is going to use, who God is going to put there? No. But you, because you did not allow God to put people there, you choose from yourself. Get this book. The message is inside here. Do not give an F it's on this way. For you to know what I'm talking about is true. I woke up in the middle of the night and I went in prayer for him. And then after somewhere, I said to myself, I said, I bet this black man, because God just showed me things about him. But in Nigeria, the president you ordained recently, God just, it's a room. Everything was done in a room with a group of some men and few ladies, and then that's how we do it. Nothing is secret in the eyes of God. If he show you the mirror of what you do, you will be surprised. Don't be surprised and say, how did this guy know this? I didn't know it. It's God. It's God, the maker of heaven and earth. He will reveal all your secrets to his children. He will first warn you. If you refuse to repent, then he will expose you and play with you openly. Why you may be saying, why, how did this girl know? But she wasn't in Nigeria for her to know that this thing was organized from the House of Parliament. But somebody above you who see what you are doing in secret will review everything. If the America, the Germany, the England, if they are fighting and say they are going to get the Boko Haram, the man that kidnapped, I can't even put his name. God says, like, evil, you don't repeat evil out of your mouth. That's why my tongue just twitched when I wanted to even pronounce his name. But it's like the seed of Satan. Before they can get the seed of Satan, before the America, the European, before they can get to the seed of Satan that kidnapped those children, they first got to work with you politics in Nigeria. They first got to start from the top. The government got to sit you all down. For them to say to each one of you, go home and squeeze your brain, open it and do some research and do some adjustment. God of Abraham, Isaac and Israel, he will visit you soon. Then you will know that God already sent a lady to speak on YouTube to tell us that we should release the guest. Yes, but we were thinking, who is she? But God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel will surely visit you. He will surely visit you. You kidnap those guests from their land, from their school, and then you have your own family. You send your children all over the whole world. And then you said, but they are the poor. No. Don't forget, you may think they are poor here. They are rich in heaven. Those guys, they are even, they are sky already. If you don't know, they are a blessing for their generation. What if those children wasn't kidnapped? Nobody will know that all what you are all doing there is evil. Those children, the Satan may think is using something evil, but God will bring good out of it. Those children, God even use them. Satan think is doing evil against them. Those children are even a savior. They save a lot of people that they have been kidnapped in that country for many years before they kidnap those children. Those children, they are a blessing, they are a star. Their family, they may be watching this. Those children, they are a blessing, they are a star. Let their name be continue being in your family. Don't raise their name up. Don't forget their name in your family because they are star. You cannot see the soul that those children win, but they win so they deliver people. If those guests wasn't kidnapped, nobody will know about what is going on. The whole world will not know about Nigeria. But because of those deaths now, they help Nigeria. They help those who Boko Haram have been kidnapped many years now. Some of them are coming out because of those deaths. If those girls wasn't kidnapped, we will not, all those that they have been kidnapped many years before those deaths, they will not be coming out now. May God have mercy on us. Nigeria, police, release those girls. Release those girls. Go back to the seed of Satan that you deposit those children to. And have the seed of Satan that hold those children to release them in whichever area that those children were kidnapped. Because you kidnapped them. You see, I'm not in Nigeria for you to know. God know and see. You know where you put them. You did not put them in a one location. You divide them, you separate those children. You may say, does this girl know? I am a Christian. I am a child of the living God. I come and I deliver the message to you through Yeshua, through Jesus Christ, the Son of God. He's the one that sees you. Yeshua, Adonai, he sees everything you are calling secret. The Son of God, he sees what you are calling secret. And he brings everything out to open. For you to know that he loves you. He loves you, even you are a sinner. Judas is that betrayed Jesus Christ. Jesus still loves him because it's a God of second chance. He still has mercy. He can still have mercy on you. Let God have mercy on you. He will forgive you. If you don't need to go to any pastor, you can plead for mercy wherever you are, and God will hear you. He will forgive you. And what you got to do now is to arrange how those things will be released, and God will have mercy on you. And all the cause that is in your life, God will raise it up. You now organize and arrange how those debts will be released. Because if you don't do that before it's too late, the outcome of it, you will not like it. Bye.